All right, I want to go to this issue before we break, Keith. Fire ants, if you're watching this at home from the suburbs or the urban parts of Australia, you think this doesn't apply to you. Well, it does if you want to eat and you want to, you know, build a house and everything else that comes from country areas. They're on the march. They're getting lower down the Australian border than they've ever been before. We're told in confidential documents there's literally hundreds of millions of dollars short in an eradication and emergency plan. Not happening at a federal level, not enough happening with the Palaszczuk government. Now, you tell me, am I over-egging the custard here? Should we be as worried as I am?
Oh, you should absolutely be worried, Peter. This is a huge problem. And the Palaszczuk government can't claim they've got no coin. They've just robbed an extra almost $6 billion last financial year out of coal communities and coal businesses in Queensland. They've got a heap of money. They've got plenty for public servants. And this is a real challenge. I mean, if these animals get away, fire ants... they're potentially lethal for small children if there's enough bites. They're really toxic. They sting. Yeah. And I'm worried it'll get to the point where it's actually declared to be out of control and they just stop dealing with it.
Jeez. Google it at home if you're not sure what a fire ant is. And you're absolutely right. It can be lethal for kids, pets, whole box and dice. Gary Hargrave, Keith Pitt, thank you as always. See you next week.